Hello, I'm Monika Gause, I'm a teacher, and I've written several books on Adobe Illustrator. In this video, I'm going to show you the essentials of the gradient mesh. You've probably experienced gradient meshes behaving not too well. They build all kinds of weird lines when you create them. Now, why is it so? I'm using a banana as an example. Bananas are great for this because when drawing bananas, you need these mesh lines going through from here all the way down there. And bananas are bent shapes. And this kind of shapes make gradient meshes misbehave. Now I'm selecting this and use the gradient mesh tool and click down here to create the grid line. Now you see, with this lines, it's impossible to build the banana. The line go all kinds of weird ways. Why does it behave like that? Now, to show you this, I'm going to draw a rectangle and create another grid. Here's my mesh. And you see, it's very regular. And this doesn't just happen because it's a rectangle, but all meshes are like this. And I'm going to show you the anatomy of a mesh. To show this, I'm using the free plugin Mesh Tormentor. It has this function that shows the basics of the mesh. I'm going to click the button. And what you see is there are 4 points highlighted and this as the starting point. These are the corner points of the mesh in this version. So it's basically a table. Now I'm going to do this on the banana as well. And again you see 4 corners. So every mesh has these 4 corners. Deep down in their black souls, they are tables. They're just an Excel table. Now, in order to work with them, you need to adjust the table in a way that it fits your object. So you have to align and move the mesh around so that it is bent and fits your banana shape. That's actually one way to work with meshes. You start with a rectangle and then move the points around, using the direct selection tools and all the other tools Illustrator has to offer. That's a very tedious task because it's much more easier to just draw a path and then make a mesh out of it by clicking into it. So how can we do that? Is that possible as well? Yes, it is. I'm going to revert all this. So that's my path again. And to convert this into the grid I need to show Illustrator the corner points I want to use. To do this, I use the direct selection tool and select 4 of these points. Those points are the ones I want to use as corner points for my grid. And then I go to Object, Create Gradient Mesh. And I'm going to use only few rows and columns. Let's see this. Now there's the line I need. This line is perfect to draw my banana. So let's say OK. Now the next thing I need to do is clean this up. In order to continue working with it, I need to always clean it up and then draw the next line and then clean it up again and set the next line. Now you see when I go over it with the direct selection tool, there are points highlighted, but I can't really select them. You know, they are there and they kind of makes some weird moves, but I can't select them, so I need to get rid of them. Using the Delete Anchor Point tool, they are highlighted and I can click on them and get rid of them. Now that was the wrong one. Need to click here and again the wrong one. This and this and this. I don't need them. Select this again and adjust my grid line. And maybe I need to fine-tune this. In order to do so, you can use the Add Anchor Point tool and add a different kind of anchor point tool that you can actually move around. And also on this side, you need to get the handle. Let's see. I need to zoom into that a little further and actually grab the handle and move that around. Now what you can also do, let's pretend I want to have this somewhere else. I can take the gradient mesh tool and I want to move this along the path here. To do so, I can press shift and you see it moves along that path. That's very handy because you don't change too much, you just move it. Same works down here. You can also just press shift and move it along. And of course, here as well. Now, I need some more grid lines and I can just zoom in a little and then create the next grid line and again press shift and move it where I need it. And the next lines I create, they all orient on the ones that are already there. So it's important you create a grid line, clean it up, and make the next one. And this is the hidden secret behind gradient meshes.